Esteemed friends, good afternoon. I am glad to welcome and congratulate you on a great, momentous event, the laying at the Baltic Shipyard of a new nuclear icebreaker, which will be given the glorious name Stalingrad. This is yet another tribute to the memory and unbending courage of the defenders and residents of the Volga stronghold, to the valor and bravery of the participants of the grand battle, which in many ways determined the outcome not only of the Great Patriotic War, but of the entire Second World War, and, without exaggeration, influenced the fate of humanity. Today's date of the laying of a new powerful icebreaker is especially significant. It was precisely in these days, in the fierce battles for Stalingrad, that a radical turning point occurred. The offensive operation of Soviet troops began, which ended with the encirclement and complete defeat of the enemy grouping. And from the banks of the Volga, our troops irresistibly moved forward toward victory. I am sure that the new icebreaker Stalingrad will worthily bear this proud name. Working in the harsh conditions of the Arctic, carving a path through the ice, it will become yet another symbol of the talent, strength, and creative energy of our people, of their ability to set before themselves and bring to life the most daring plans, to withstand the most difficult times. Today, Russia is actively and consistently developing its unique icebreaker fleet, replenishing it with modern equipment. In this, without doubt, there is a huge merit of our remarkable shipbuilders, nuclear scientists, engineers, designers, workers, and specialists of various professions. Thank you for your immense work, for your focus on achieving the maximum result. It is precisely thanks to you that Russia today is the only country in the world capable of carrying out serial construction of powerful, reliable nuclear icebreakers. And, which is fundamental, on the basis of its own domestic technologies. Thus, the icebreaker Stalingrad will become the sixth serial ship in its project. The first four icebreakers, the lead icebreaker Arctica, and the three serial vessels Sibir, Ural, and Yakutia, are already successfully standing watch in Arctic waters, ensuring the passage of cargo along the northern sea route. The construction of two more icebreakers in this series, Chukotka and Leningrad, continues at the Baltic Shipyard. The volume of work ahead is large. I am sure that it will proceed rhythmically in accordance with the established deadlines. We will continue, despite all current difficulties and challenges, to increase the capabilities of our icebreaker fleet, to develop domestic shipbuilding, to create breakthrough scientific and technological groundwork. The tasks before us are, without exaggeration, historical. It is important to consistently strengthen Russia's positions in the Arctic, to fully realize our country's logistical potential, to ensure the development of a promising transarctic transport corridor from Saint Petersburg to Vladivostok. And of course, the comprehensive arrangement of Arctic cities and settlements directly depends on the icebreakers, on high ice class vessels, on the development of the infrastructure of Arctic ports, the creation of new jobs here, the improvement of the level and quality of life of people. All this is among our key priorities for the years ahead. In conclusion, I want to wish the glorious team of the Baltic Shipyard, the workers of the United Shipbuilding Corporation, Rosatom, and other companies involved in this project, everyone who contributes to the development of the Arctic, to the strengthening and development of Russia, success and all the very best.